The Bible does not diminish marriage, sex, or people. It actually elevates them, marriage, sex, and people, so that they're viewed with more love and respect than they are anywhere else in the world. According to the Bible, marriage, sex, and people are sacred and beautiful things that should lead to life and flourishing, but which, when misused, can lead to a lot of hurt, to broken hearts, sadness. And so we really need to hear what this pastor says to us today when he says, let marriage be held in honor among all. Now, we have to say at the outset that Jesus had a very high view of marriage. And we sometimes think, a lot of times when we talk about marriage today and society and where society is going, we think that in the old days, you know, things used to be great and everyone just had this high view of marriage. You know, in Jesus's day, people really valued marriage, and it's today. It's our culture today that has really corrupted things and gone south, but that's actually not necessarily the case. In fact, one of the major schools of thought in Jesus's day was that a husband could divorce his wife for any reason he wanted. There was one very popular rabbi who said, look, if you don't like your wife's cooking, you can give her a certificate of divorce. If she burned the eggs, you know, like that's a legitimate reason for getting a divorce. If you wanted a younger, prettier wife, according to this school of thought, like that was a legitimate reason for you to go and get a divorce. And that was devastating for women, denigrating to women in a society where the right of divorce exclusively belonged to the husband. So if you were a woman, you couldn't go to your husband and seek a divorce. Only your husband could do that. And basically it was free reign. Husbands could get a divorce for whatever reason they wanted, at least according to one very popular school of thought in Jesus's day. And so Jesus's teaching on marriage and on divorce elevated women and it elevated marriage, because Jesus taught that you can just do this for any reason. You can just go and get a divorce because you didn't like your spouse, their cooking, right? And so we think about what Jesus did. He talks about marriage as this act of God uniting two people together. It's something that is supposed to be honored, and that's what this text is telling us here. Jesus had a high view of marriage. The apostles and the disciples who followed him had a very high view of marriage. And the word honor here in verse 4, it says, let marriage be held in honor above or by everyone, is a word that was often used in association with describing gold or precious stones. The idea is that marriage is something that should be valued by the church and by society. We might even translate this verse, let marriage be precious to everyone.